Hello! Welcome to this short tutorial. Let's see in a short time the most important and basic features you need to know to start using the newest Autodesk AutoCAD 2020. Do not forget to check out our YouTube channel and our official website for extra content, free video tutorials, and much more. Autodesk AutoCAD is a professional computer-aided design product used in both academic and business environments and available in several versions on the market. The general version covers most of the features you need to create 2D and 3D drawings like floor plans, constructions, buildings, and structural designs. The other versions are more focused on different kinds of projects, such as AutoCAD Architectural, Engineering, Civil, Mechanical, and so on. In this video, we are going to see how to create basic 2D drawings with the general version of AutoCAD. You can check our YouTube channel for more highlights on 3D drawings and more advanced tutorials on AutoCAD. When opening AutoCAD, its Start page opens, divided in two sections at the bottom, Learn and Create. Learn collects several tips and suggestions, including how-to videos and online resources from Autodesk. Create, all the options to start with AutoCAD to restart from any recent document. Browse for your existing projects with Open Files on the left, or start from a fresh new one by going to Start Drawing. Let's just start from a new blank project. The new document or drawing opens on the main workspace, under a new tab on top, next to the Start page and called Drawing 1 by default. The workspace is made by the ribbon on top, with the full list of tools and features to draw, modify, and export, the visualization tools on the right, and the command line at the bottom, used to insert functions and tool options. The rest of the workspace is the whole project preview, where you can draw and edit. This follows the Cartesian system, or gizmo, as referenced in the bottom left corner, fixing the horizontal direction as x-axis in red color and the vertical direction as y-axis in green color. The same workspace can be customized by either using the Minimize button to size the ribbon properly or the View tab to show or hide panels and modules as you need. Now let's see how to make 2D drawings inside AutoCAD. You can drop lines, circles, ellipses, and polygons with the tools inside the Draw section under the Home tab. You can hover over each tool to get tips on how to use it, whose process can change depending on the kind of object and also on the kind of tool you choose from the list. In this video, we are going to see just the default tools. Use Line or Polyline to draw segments inside the project. Fix the first node as starting point and a second one to place the first segment. Then you can drop consecutive segments sharing the last node until you use the Escape key to stop drawing. Use Circle to drop circles by fixing its center first and then a second point for its radius. Enable Arc to draw an arc by fixing two points to define the basic segment, and then a third one to fix the arc curvature. Use Rectangle to drop a simple rectangle by fixing two points. Whereas, enable Polygon to create a regular polygon by typing its number of sides, applying with the Enter key, and fixing center and last point. Then, use the Ellipse tool to drop an ellipse from three defined points. Once the object is dropped on the workspace, the current tool gets disabled automatically. You can enable it again by using the Enter key and go on drawing. While drawing any object, AutoCAD shows its preview with useful measurements on length and angles. Angles are measured in degrees in respect to the x-axis, whereas length and radius are unitless. The measurement unit for these can be set by typing units inside the command line and using the Enter key. Then, inside Drawing Units, specify the format, the precision, and the unit to use as reference under Insertion Scale. With the object in progress, you can also define and set precise values on it by using your keyboard instead of your cursor. In this case, you can use the Tab key to go for the next or the previous property while checking the preview in progress and then apply the result with the Enter key or undo all with the Escape key. To help you realize drawings fast and precisely, AutoCAD has several drawing aids available, all collected in the bottom right corner of the workspace. You can use Grid Mode to show or hide the grid, Snap Mode to enable or disable snappings to the grid itself, Ortho Mode to move your cursor just along the X or Y axis, and Object Snap to snap to fundamental object key points in green color, such as squares for endpoints and verticals, triangles for midpoints, circles for centers, and crosses for intersections. AutoCAD also creates green dash guidelines starting from the hovered object key points in order to draw along parallel, perpendicular directions, or make intersections. You can manage the list of key points and directions to take into account from the list next to Object Snap. You can use the visualization tools on the right to check the status and the results of your drawings. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out around your cursor, and the pan tool to click and drag around your workspace. Use the escape key to finish with the tool. You can also use the 3D view cube to check your project from any point of view. As for this 2D drawing, you can use the arrows in the top right corner to rotate by 90 degrees or drag the basic circumference to rotate in 2D as you like. You can also make and manage your drawings by using your keyboard. Let's draw a polyline, for example. As you enable the polyline tool, you can drop the object by using either your cursor to fix the nodes or your keyboard to insert values directly. In addition, you can use your up and down arrow keys to browse inside the list of options within the gray dialog box. In order to change the way to draw the object or specify its properties depending on the current drawing step. For example, you can choose Arc to start drawing curved sides and Line to return to straight sides. Remember to use the Enter key to apply. You can also use the command line at the bottom to enable tools and manage drawings. For example, you can type Polyline and apply with the Enter key to enable the Polyline tool. You can also choose between the several tool options seen in the gray dialog box before by typing the character highlighted in blue color that corresponds to the interested option, applying with the Enter key. Now, let's see how to edit objects inside AutoCAD. When no tools are enabled, your cursor is in selection mode, showing a small square on its center and ready to interact with any object. You can hover over it to view information and click on it to select it. This will be highlighted in blue color with several editing nodes on it you can use to change and edit its shape. When selecting lines, arcs, circles, and ellipses, big squared nodes show up. You can use the central one to move and place the object, and all the others to shape it. You can also hover over these nodes to get measurements on angles, length, and radius. In case of lines and arcs, you can also enable additional editing options from the list next to your cursor. You can choose Stretch to move the current endpoint. Lengthen to size the segment or arc length, and Radius to size the arc radius. In case of polylines, rectangles, and polygons, you have big nodes for the verticals and smaller ones for the sides. If you hover over the big nodes, you get measurements on the object and you can either add or remove the selected vertex. Choose Stretch Vertex to move it and shape the sides connected to it. Consider that you do not have any central node to move polylines directly. You will have to use the Move tool we are going to see shortly. Whereas you can hover over the smaller node to manage and edit the polyline sides, choose Stretch to move the entire side. Convert to Arc to turn the straight side into a curved one, and Convert to Line to return to a straight side. You can cut, copy, and paste a selected object by using Ctrl and X, C, and V respectively. To remove an object, just select it and use the Delete key. You can use Ctrl and Z to undo any action if you make a mistake. The Gizmo system is indeed an object that can be managed by using its nodes. You can move this reference with a square node and rotate its X and Y axis with its blue circles. Consider that the whole project grid will get updated to this change. You can find other advanced tools to edit your 2D objects inside the Modify section under the Home tab. To use these, you can either select the interested objects first and then enable the tool to start editing, or enable the tool first and then select all the objects. Indeed, the multiple selection allows to edit all the objects in the same way and in one move. You can click on each object to go on with your selection precisely, or use the lasso selections to make this faster. If you click and hold while dragging your cursor towards the right direction, you create a window lasso, selecting all the objects fully contained within the blue area. Whereas, if you drag towards the left direction, you will make a green crossing lasso, which also includes the objects that simply cross the borders. You can use the Escape key to deselect all. Once the objects are selected, you can use the Move tool to move, Rotate to rotate the objects, defining rotation center and angle, and Scale to scale the object by saving its aspect ratio. Now, let's see how to save and export your drawings from AutoCAD. To save your whole project, including its options and object properties, go to the AutoCAD icon in the top left corner and go to Save As. Type the project name and set where to save it. AutoCAD Drawings, saving everything, have a .dwg as file format. Whereas to export your drawing, open the Output tab and choose Plot to set the options to print your work or export to share it as a .dwfx, .dwf, or a .pdf read-only document. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our YouTube channel for a general 2D and 3D overview on what you can do with AutoCAD.